Sher Shah Suri born Farid Khan Lodhi 1486 in Bihar was the founder of the Suri Empire in the northern part of the Indian subcontinent with its capital in Sasaram in modern-day Bihar. He introduced the currency of rupee. An ethnic Pashtun Sher Shah took control of the Mughal Empire in 1538. After his accidental death in 1545, his son Islam Shah became his successor. He first served as a private before rising to become a commander in the Mughal army under Babur and then the governor of Bihar. In 1537, when Babur's son Humayun was elsewhere on an expedition, Sher Shah overran the state of Bengal and established the Suri dynasty. A brilliant strategist, Sher Shah proved himself as a gifted administrator as well as a capable general. His reorganization of the empire laid the foundations for the later Mughal emperors, notably Akbar, son of Humayun. During his seven-year rule from 1538 to 1545, he set up a new economic and military administration, issued the first rupee from Tikka, and organized the postal system of the Indian subcontinent. Some of his strategies and contributions were later idealized by the Mughal emperors, most notably Akbar. Suri further developed Humayun's Dina Panah city and named it Shergah, and revived the historical city of Pataliputra, which had been in decline since the 7th century as Patna. He extended the Grand Trunk Road from Chittagong in the frontiers of the province of Bengal in northeast India to Kabul in Afghanistan in the far northwest of the country. The influence of his innovations and reforms extended far beyond his brief reign. His arch foe Humayun referred to him as Ustad-e-Badshaham, teacher of kings. Early life and origin. Sher Shah Suri was born in Sasaram, a city in the state of Bihar in present-day India, into a Pashtun family. His surname Suri was taken from his Pashtun Sur tribe. The name Sher was conferred upon him for his courage when, as a young man, he killed a tiger that leapt suddenly upon the king of Bihar. His grandfather Ibrahim Khan Suri was a landlord, Jagirdar, in Narnaul area and represented Delhi rulers of that period. Conquest of Bihar and Bengal. Farid Khan started his service under Bahar Khan Lohani, the Mughal governor of Bihar. Because of his valor, Bahar Khan rewarded him the title Sher Khan. After the death of Bahar Khan, Sher Khan became the regent ruler of the minor Sultan Jalal Khan. Later, sensing the growth of Sher Shah's power in Bihar, Jalal sought the assistance of Ghiyasuddin Mahmud Shah, the independent Sultan of Bengal. Ghiyasuddin sent an army under General Ibrahim Khan, but Sher Khan defeated the force at the Battle of Surajgarh in 1534 after forming an alliance with Ujjainiya Rajputs and other local chieftains. Thus he achieved complete control of Bihar. In 1538, Sher Khan attacked Bengal and defeated Mahmud Shah. But he could not capture the kingdom because of the sudden expedition of Emperor Humayun. On the 26th of June 1539, Sher Khan faced Humayun in the Battle of Chauzar and defeated him. Assuming the title Farid al-Din Sher Shah, he defeated Humayun once again at Kannauj in May 1540 and forced him out of India. Conquest of Malwa. After the death of Bahadur Shah of Gujarat in 1537, Qadir Shah became the new ruler of Malwa Sultanate. He then turned for support towards the Rajput and Muslim noblemen of the Khilji rule of Malwa. Kupat Rai and Puran Mal, sons of Raja Silhadi, accepted service under the regime of Malwa in recognition of their interest in the Resen region. By 1540, Kupat Rai had died and Puran Mal had become the dominant force in eastern Malwa. In 1542, Sher Shah conquered Malwa without a fight and Qadir Shah fled to Gujarat. He then appointed Shujaat Khan as the governor of Malwa, who reorganized the administration and made Saringpur the seat of Malwa's government. Sher Shah then ordered Puran Mal to be brought before him. Uran Mal agreed to accept his lordship and left his brother Chaturbhuj under Sher Shah's service. In exchange, Sher Shah vowed to safeguard Uran Mal and his land. The Muslim women of Chanderi, which Sher Shah had taken under his rule, came to him and accused Uran Mal of killing their husbands and enslaving their daughters. They threatened to denounce Sher Shah on the day of resurrection if he did not avenge them. Upon reminding them of his pledge to safeguard Uran Mal, they told him to consult his ulema. The ulema issued a fatwa declaring that Uran Mal deserved death. Sher Shah had his troops encircle Uran Mal's camp. Upon seeing this, Uran Mal beheaded his wife and ordered the other Rajputs to kill their families too. Conquest of Marwar. In 1543, Sher Shah Suri, with a huge force of 80,000 cavalry, set out against Maldeo Rathore, a Rajput king of Marwar. Maldeo Rathore, with an army of 50,000 cavalry, advanced to face Sher Shah's army. Instead of marching to the enemy's capital, Sher Shah halted in the village of Sammel in the Pargana of Jataran, 90 kilometers east of Jodhpur. After 1 month of skirmishing, Sher Shah's position became critical owing to the difficulties of food supplies for his huge army. To resolve this situation, Sher Shah resorted to a cunning ploy. One evening, he dropped forged letters near the Maldeo's camp in such a way that they were sure to be intercepted. These letters indicated falsely that some of Maldeo's army commanders were promising assistance to Sher Shah. This caused great consternation to Maldeo, who immediately, and wrongly, suspected his commanders of disloyalty. Maldeo left for Jodhpur with his own men, abandoning his commanders to their fate. After that, Maldeo's innocent generals Jita and Kumpa fought with just a few thousand men against an enemy force of 80,000 men and cannons. In the ensuing battle of Sammel, Sher Shah emerged victoriously, but several of his generals lost their lives and his army suffered heavy losses. Sher Shah is said to have commented that, "For a few grains of bajra, I almost lost the entire kingdom of Hindustan." After this victory, Sher Shah's general Khawas Khan Magar took possession of Jodhpur and occupied the territory of Marwar. From Ajmer to Mount Abu in 1544. Death and succession. Sher Shah was killed on the 22nd of May 1545 during the siege of Kalia Fort in Bundelkhand against the Rajputs of Mahoba. When all tactics to subdue this fort failed, Sher Shah ordered the walls of the fort to be blown up with gunpowder, but he himself was seriously wounded as a result of the explosion of a mine. He was succeeded by his son Jalal Khan, who took the title of Islam Shah Suri. His mausoleum, the Sher Shah Suri tomb, 122 feet high, stands in the middle of an artificial lake at Sasarama town on the Grand Trunk Road.